Students, in this lecture, we'll discuss about signal flow graphs. This was developed by S.J. Mason. It is a graphical representation of the relationships between the variables of a set of linear algebraic equations. It consists of a network in which nodes representing each of the system variables are connected by directed branches. One is node. It represents a system variable which is equal to the sum of all incoming signals at the node. Outgoing signals from the node do not affect the value of the node variable. We'll take example. In that example, R, E, B and C are nodes in below figure. So this is a figure. You can see R, E, B and C are nodes in the figure. Okay, these are the nodes in the figure. Okay, these symbols are also representing the corresponding node variables. So this is a diagram for the reference. Okay, next we'll see. So we'll see the next terminology that is related to signal flow. Branch. A signal travels along a branch from one node to another in the direction indicated by branch arrow, and in the process gets multiplied by the gain or transmittance of the branch. For example, signal reaching the node C from node E is given by G. You can see the signal reaching in this figure. You see this figure. The signal reaching the node C from node E is given by GE. GE, where G is branch transmittance and branch is directed from node E to node C. So value of node variable C is equal to GE. Okay, so you can see the signal reaching the node C from node E is given by GE. Okay. Then next, node as a summing point. Node variable X1 is expressed as A21 X2. You can see here in this figure A21 X2 plus A31 X3. A31 X3 plus A41 X4 into 4. Got it? So what is the node variable X1 expressed as A21 X2 plus A31 X3 plus A41 X4. So these are incoming. Okay, is equal to sum of all incoming signals. Sum of all incoming signals. So you can see here. So how many are incoming signals? X2, X3, X4 to this node variable X1. So how this node variable expressed as A21 X2 plus A31 X3 plus A41 X4 is equal to the sum of all incoming nodes to this node variable. Okay, next we'll see node as a transmitting point. Node as a transmitting point. A node variable is transmitted. A node variable is transmitted through all its branches outgoing from the node. So when we see the signal flow graph, we can see the signal flow graph, how many are outgoing nodes? X5, X6 are there from this X1. So we have to take those values. So X5, how it is expressed, you can see here. X5 we can write here as A15X1 plus A16X1. These are the outgoing from the node. Okay, the value of the node variable is not affected by the outgoing branches. The next notation, Aij, is it, what does this Aij indicate? Is a transmittance of the branch directed from node Xi to node Xj. Next, input node or source. It is a node with only outgoing branches. So you can see R is an input node. You can see here in this figure, R is an input node. R is an input node. Okay, input node. Output node or sink. It is a node with always only incoming branches. This condition is not always met. An additional branch with unit gain may be introduced in order to meet this specified condition. For example, node C has one outgoing branch, but after introducing an additional branch with unit transmittance, the node becomes an output node. Path. It is a traversal of connected branches in the direction of the branch arrows such that no node is traversed more than once. Next, forward path. It is a path from the input node to the output node. So we'll see in this diagram which is a forward path. So you can see R, E, C. They are in the forward path. So R, E, C is the forward path loop. It is a path which originates and terminates at the same node. It is a path which originates and terminates at the same node. For example, ECBE is a loop. ECBE is a loop. ECBE is a loop. You can see here. In this figure, EC, you can see ECBE, ECBE is a loop, ECBE is a loop, ECBE is a loop. Next, non-touching loops. Loops are said to be non-touching if they do not possess any common node. Next, forward path gain. It is a product of the branch gains encountered in traversing the loop. For example, ECBE loop has loop gain minus GH. You can see here, this loop ECBE, ECBE loop has got the loop gain as G into H into minus 1. G into H into minus 1 will become minus GH. Minus GH. Minus GH. Next, construction of signal flow graph. Signal flow graph of a system is constructed from its describing equations. We'll consider a system described by the following set of equations. Okay, so the signal flow graph. So we'll go for construction of signal flow graph. The signal flow graph of a system is constructed from its describing equations. To outline the procedure, we'll consider a system which is described by the following set of equations. So what are the equations given? X2 is equal to A1 to X1 plus A3 to X3 plus A4 to X4 plus A5 to X5. X3 is equal to A23 X2 and X4 is equal to A34 X3 plus A44 X4. X5 is equal to A35 X3 plus A45 X4, where X1 is input variable and X5 is output variable. Okay, then whatever is the signal flow graph for the system, it is constructed like this. So first we'll locate the nodes. It has said X1 is input variable, X5 is output variable. So we will locate these nodes. X1 to X1, X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. We locate these nodes by small circles. Okay, then what is X2 expressed? A1 to X1 plus A3 to X3 plus A4 to X4 plus A5 to X5. So X2, what is X2? A1 to X1, A1 to X1. So you can see A1 to X1, A1 to X1 plus A3 to X3. So you can see A3 to here X2, A3 to X2 plus A4 to X4. So where is X4? Here X4, A4 to, it should come to 2, A4 to X4, A4 to X4. Plus A5 to X5, you can see, plus A5 to X5. When it is coming from 5 to node 2, A5 to X5, A5 to X5. So this is up to the first equation. Next, what is second equation? X3 is equal to A23 X2, A23 X2. So you can see A23 X3 is shown here. To X3 it is coming from node 2, so A23 X2. Okay, next, third equation, X4 is equal to A34 X4 plus A44 X4. So X4, what it is? A34 X3. This diagram is representing the first equation. Okay, so one equation is over, then second equation. So this represents second equation. X3 is equal to A23 X2. So X3 is equal to A23 X2. Second figure. Third figure, X4 is equal to A34 X3. So what is X4? A34 X3 plus A44 X4. A44 means you have to have this A4 to 4. A44 X4. Similarly, fifth equation is given by X5 is equal to A45 X4 plus A35 X3. So X5 is A45 X4 plus A35 X3. All these diagrams we have to combine. All those diagrams we have to combine. When we combine, the first diagram is here, combine second diagram. So this diagram is combined here. This third diagram is combined here, you can see. Fourth diagram is combined here. All the diagrams must be combined. That you will get it as a signal flow graph. So this is how to draw the signal flow graph by combining all the fourth equation diagrams. Okay, this is okay. Next we'll see about Mason's gain formula. So what is this Mason's gain formula? There is a relation between an input variable and output variable. That relation between input variable and output variable in case of a signal flow graph, it is given by the net gain between the input and output nodes and is known as overall gain of the system. So it is given by the net gain between the input and output nodes and is known as the overall gain of the system. So Meissen's gain formula for the determination of the overall system gain is given by this. T is equal to 1 by delta summation pk delta k, sorry, pk dou k, where k is a variable. Okay, where pk represents path gain of kth forward path. Path gain of kth forward path, then this delta represents determinant of the graph. And that determinant of the graph is equal to 1 minus sum of loop gains of all individual loops plus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops minus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of three non-touching loops, etc. Then, so we can write the delta as 1 minus summation pm1m summation with limit m pm2 minus summation limit pm3, where pmr is a gain product of mth possible combination of r non-touching loops. Delta k, the value of delta for the part of the graph not touching the kth forward path. T is overall gain of the system. So we'll illustrate the use of Meissen's formula by finding the overall gain of the signal flow graph, which will be shown in the figure. The following conclusions are drawn by inspection of the signal flow graph. So you can see there are two forward paths with path gains. So this diagram we have to see, there are two forward paths with path gains A12, A23, A34, A45 is one forward path. So that is why it is written P1 as A12, A23, A34, A45. P2 is, what is P2? A12, A23, A35. So we can see one more forward path denoted by P2, A12, A23, A35. This is one more forward path. Okay. So these are the two forward paths with path gains. Next, we have to find how many individual loops are there. So we'll find how many individual loops are there and we'll write the path gains. When we see this figure, there are five loops and we'll write the forward path loop gains individual. P1, one is considered as one individual loop. So it is written as A23, A32. So this A23, A32 is one loop denoted by P1. Next, P2, A12, A23, A35 will be one loop. P21 is second individual loop, so it is given by A23, A34, A42. You can see A23, A34, A42 is one more loop. Okay. Next, P31 is one loop. P44. So this P44, you can see this. Next is P31 is one more loop, P44. So you can see 4 to 4. So P44 is one loop. Next. P41. One more loop is denoted by P41, which it is A23, A34. A45, A52. So you can see A23, A34, A45, A52. A23, A34, A45, A52 is one more loop. Okay, next. P51 is one loop, which is denoted by P51 is denoted as one loop. A23, A35, A52. A23, A34. Okay, next is A23, A35, A52. A23, A35, A52. You can see A23, A35, A52 is one more loop. There is no further loop. So total there are 5 individual loops with loop gain. Then we have to see, is there any possibility of 2 possible combinations of 2 non-touching loops, and we'll write the loop gains. Two non-touching loops, they should not be non-touching. So in that figure there are 2 non-touching loops. We'll write those denoted by P12 and P22. P12 is A23, A32, A44. Okay, A23, A32, A44. A23, they should be non-touching. A23, A324, you can see A23, A32 and A44 is non-touching. This is one loop, this is one loop. A23, A32, A44. These are 2 loops which are non-touching. So we have to write A23, A32, A44. Next, P22. A23, A35, A52, A5. You can see A23, A35, A23, A35, A52, A44, A23, A23, A35, A52. You can see in this diagram A23, A35, A52. This is not touching with A44. So we can write A23, A35, A52, A44, which is non-touching. Then we have to see, is there any possibility of 3 non-touching loops, 4 non-touching loop? So those are all zeros. There are no three non-touching loops. Then we'll write delta. Delta is 1 minus, what is delta? We have seen 1 minus summation of PM1 plus summation of PM2 minus summation of PM3 is 1. So delta is, we have to write 1 minus. So how many individual loops are there? We have to write 1 minus A23. So we have to write the individual loops. A23, A32, A2 plus A23, A342, A42. This is non-touching loops, we have to write, plus A44. How many non-touching loops are there? We write all those. Plus A23, A34, A45, A52. Next is A23, A35, A52. These are 5 individual loops. We write the sum of that. So 1 minus plus, it will be the sum of 2 non-touching loops. 1 minus over next plus sum of 2 non-touching loops, which is A23, A32, A44 plus A23, A35, A52, A44. So this is the then. Fifth is first forward path. We'll see the first forward path. It is in touch with all loops. You see this diagram. This first forward path is A12, A23, A34, A5. It is in touch with all the loops. It is in touch with all the loops. Due to that, delta 1 is 1. Due to that, delta 1 is 1. The second forward path is not in touch with one loop. So, you see the second diagram. The second forward path is not in touch with one loop. What is that? We'll see now. So, it is, which is a second forward path? A12, A23, A35. A12, A23, A35. Which is a second for A12, A23, A35. A12, A23, A35. You see second forward path A12, A23, A35. It is not in touch with A44. So we have tried that. We'll write delta 2 as 1 minus A44. Okay. Then, so from Mason's gain formula, we have T is x5 by x1. x5 by x1 is nothing but x5 by x1. It is nothing but P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 by delta. P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 by delta, which is equal to A12, A23, A34, A45 plus A12, A23, A35 into 1 minus A44. P1 delta 1 is 1. So delta 1 is 1 means A12, A23, A34 into 1 plus P2 delta 2. P2 A12, A23, A35 delta 2 is 1 minus A44 divided by delta. So delta is 1 minus A23, A32 minus A 1 minus divided by delta. Delta is already determined. Substitute that delta. So this is how to find the transfer function. Okay. This is how to find the transfer function T. P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 by delta. So, we'll stop here. You go through this. I request all of you to go through this. In next lecture, I'll solve the problems.